I'm back again. Sorry I didn't make any videos last week. I was really busy with school summer projects, with finding a gown for my 316, to soccer. I was really busy last week. I'm really sorry I didn't post any. But I am back with the daily routine. If you guys want to know my schedule on when I upload videos, it's Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. And sometimes Monday, if I am in the mood for it. Sometimes. But today, I'm going to be showing you guys a DIY binder design. I'm going to show you how to take this disgusting binder that has these white little marks and you're just embarrassed about it and missing a pocket and also has a broken pocket into an awesome binder that has the most cutest design inside. It's just awesome, guys. Look at that. Pockets were broken, but now they're fixed and it actually works. I also made another one. It's like the most awesome binder ever. It has like the new splings, you know? I'm going to show you guys how to make these. I had a lot of fun making it, and it was so much fun to do. And literally, you guys are gonna love it. So yeah, let's hop into the video. Okay, these are all the supplies that you are going to use to make this awesome binder. All you're gonna need is some scissors, designer duct tape, and a binder. So the first thing you're gonna do is rip off the front pocket of the binder, of the cover of it. But I struggled with it, so I am going to grab my scissors and cut it out. Now take your favorite designer duct tape and measure how long it's going to be. And make sure you add an extra 2 inch of the duct tape so that way it could be wrapped on top of the binder. After you cut out the tape that you measured, place it on the label where it tells you the inch of the binder.
Sorry I didn't record it, it was really hard to do. With those little bits on the bottom and on the top, I just wrapped it around the binder. Don't worry, those things will be covered up.
So I was doing a repeated pattern on my binder, but I didn't record it because it was hard to film. So I'm going to come back when it's halfway done. As you can see, we're not done. The outer part of the binder is not covered up, and we want to cover up those zigzags tape inches inside.
I'm going to stop telling you guys what I'm going to be doing because I'm not making any sense right now. Just follow what I'm demonstrating you on the video.
And you're going to repeat the same step, but to the bottom of the binder.
I'm not afraid to So I had a little bit of tape onto it, so all I did was cut it out. And then you're going to cover up those little edges on the bookmark of the binder. And this is what the inside cover looks like. And by accident, I did the wrong side. The side that doesn't have a pocket. My bad. Sorry, guys. But we're still not done, guys, so let's keep on going. Again, just follow what I'm doing on the video. And yeah, that's all done with, but there's still more to do. So now I'm going to be taking a brown piece of paper and I'm going to write the binder's use. So this is going to be for English, and I'm just going to write it on the paper and place it on the cover of the binder. And this is a choice. This is if you guys want to do it. And you could cut out the paper in any shape or form, but I just did it like this. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you guys liked it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's my beginning of the back to school series. I know, back to school, I hate it. But I'm going to show you how to make back to school a little bit more fun on the edge. So hope you guys liked this video. And if you did, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Hope you guys like it. So yeah, bye guys, hope you liked it.